Wow, I don't know if I can live up to that. I have to think about that for a minute. I just came here really today to thank everybody involved with this. I was not involved with this petition drive at all, and I've anybody who knows me knows I couldn't organize a one-car funeral. So the fact that this has happened is just leaves me speechless. The main thing that gets to me is I realize I don't deserve all this. I mean, but I also know that it's really not about me. It's about some basic issues that affect all journalists and all Americans. You know, when the my lawyers always tell me never to talk about my case, but there's a couple things I can say. And one is that the Justice Department and the Obama administration are the ones who turned this really into a fundamental fight over press freedom. In their appeal to the Fourth Circuit, they said that this case, the central issue of this case was not some details or specifics or anything, that the fundamental thing that this case was about was that there was no such thing as a reporter's privilege. If you read the government's brief in the Fourth Circuit appeal, that's what they say. There is no such thing as a reporter's privilege. And so they turned this case into a showdown over the First Amendment and over the freedom of the press in the United States. And so I'm happy to carry on that fight, but it wasn't me who really started it. I think what, you know, this has been a long case. I got subpoenaed in 2008 first. But what I can say now is with all of these people showing their support, I'm willing to keep fighting. Because now I know that I have just an enormous group of people supporting me. And one of the things that I'd like to say is that the real reason I'm doing this is for the future of journalism. My oldest son, Tom, standing right there, is a journalist. And I want to make sure that the same protections that I've had in my career are there for the future reporters in America, because there is no way we could do our jobs if we don't have the ability to have aggressive investigative reporting in America and to have the ability to maintain confidential sources. There is just no way to conduct aggressive investigative reporting without a reporter's privilege of some kind, without confidential sources. And I don't believe you can have a democracy without aggressive investigative reporting and without freedom of the press. So I just wanted to come here again and say thank you to everyone. It's just really amazing. Thanks. Well, I didn't really want to answer questions, but I mean, it's obviously had an effect, but it's but I'm trying to keep working, so I'm just trying to do what I can. But thanks.